Hello everybody, I'm Kavendu and welcome to my channel. A few months back I published my review of the Anycubic Causa 3D printer, which has been working really well until this point. It was a relatively easy to build DIY kit and generates great prints, and therefore I've not been in need of installing any upgrades except for the fan adapter a long time ago. However, at one point I removed a PETG print and destroyed parts of the build plate sticker. And as normal printer's tape doesn't really hold PETG on a cold pad, I thought it was finally time to start upgrading. Before I want to start, it's worth to mention that I planned the upgrades carefully and printed everything before I started to take the printer apart, so the upgrade process took just about one day in my case. The first thing is the addition of a heated bed. It allows PLA and PETG prints to stick to the build plate with normal painter's tape easily and is needed for printing ABS. The main problem is that the PCB heated bed I received has a bigger diameter than the glass plate, but I managed to find an upgrade that works with this combination. I printed it in orange PETG to prevent warping on the A8, only because the sticker was already broken at this point. Before I installed the heated bed, I added some cotton insulation to it to allow for higher temperature and reduce heating times. It reaches 105 degrees Celsius, the factory maximum, without any problems. To cope with the extra thickness, I added a normal M4 nut to the middle screws between the two parts. However, the glass plate is still a little bit wobbly, and therefore I tape it down using the normal painter's tape. To avoid overheating of the electronics, especially due to excess heat from the heated bed, I chose to move all electronics to an extra case, mounted on the back extrusion. My design not only mounts the Tri-Gorilla mainboard and up to two MOSFET modules, but was also designed to fit a stepper driver cooling tunnel and includes an adapter to use it using a normal 40mm fan. Its simple design allows all parts to be printed without supports on a normal Anycubic Causa, but with the cost of some extra M3 screws needed for the covers. The whole case can be mounted to the bottom extrusions as well. I had to extend some cables and installed only one MOSFET module to bypass the high current needed for the heated bed. Similarly to the electronics box, I remixed my PSU box to fit the S2512 PSU and added the possibility to mount it to an extrusion. I placed it just above the electronic box. The 20 amps PSU is needed for the operation of the heated bed, and therefore I chose to go with two pairs of 1.5 square millimeter cables, one for the electronics and one for the heated bed MOSFET to be electrically safe. The printer uses an inlet that not only holds a standard socket, but also an illuminated switch and a 10 amps fuse, which I will probably replace with a lower one, as I've done on my A8. Last but not least, the extruder motor is now mounted on the top triangle, with a spool holder designed to fit on there as well. The design not only reduces the printer's footprint, but also makes it look very nice. I needed to adapt the extruder motor direction for getting it to work, which is possible by either changing two wires on a plug or changing directly in the firmware. A complete re-level was necessary to get ready for printing again. In the near future, I will put on some LED strips to the undersides of the top extrusions using some profile covers and will also install some belt tensioners to get rid of the last wobble. As a conclusion, it's worth to mention that these are probably the last upgrades I will install to this machine, as it is very good and generates nice prints. Thank you very much for watching this video, and as always, all links are provided in the video description. Have a nice day.